for today's lecture of Ganit Pravinya. In today's lecture, we are going to solve next questions in the exercise 1. Okay, so the next question is question number 16. Choose the digit 7 having lesser place value in the number 7735. If the 0 is placed immediately to the left of that 7, what new number will be formed? Write your answer in words. You got the question? See what the question is telling. Choose the digit 7 in the lesser place value. Choose the digit 7 having lesser place value in the number 7735. So here there is one number, 7735. Okay. So this is, we can say this is our original number. This is our original number, 7735. Then what they are telling, if the 0 is placed immediately to the left of that 7. See, in this number we have to choose the digit 7. We have to choose the digit 7 having lesser place value. Now see, in this number there are 2 times 7. 7 which is at hundreds place and 7 which is at thousands place. Okay, so out of these 2, we have to choose the 7 having lesser place value, means lowest place value, lower place value, which is that obviously 100. 100 is less than 1000, that correct. So this digit, these 7, the digit 7 which is at hundreds place, it is the it is having lesser place value, right? So we have to choose this. What we have to do, if the 0 is placed immediately to the left of that 7, now what we have to do, we have to place 0, we have to put 0 immediately to the left, this is our left side, right? So left of this 7 means 0 will come here. So the new number which will be formed after placing 0 to the left of this 7, it will be C. This 7 I am writing as it is. At the left of this, on the left of this 7, we'll put 0 and then this 7 will be written, okay? And remaining digits as it is. Understood what we have done? We have placed 0 on the left side, 0 to the left side of that this 7, okay? So the new number is formed, and what is that number? We have to write number name of this number. So this 1's, 10's, 100, 1000 and 10,000. This is 1's group, this is 1000's group, okay? So the number name is, what is number name? How many thousand? 70,000, right? So 70,000. And in 1's group there is 735. 735. So this is the number name of this new number which is formed by placing 0 to the left of the 7 having lesser place value in the number 7735. Understood? Okay. Now we will move towards the next question, that is question number 17. Which is the middle digit in the largest number formed by all the digits in the number 14,651 used once each? See, what is this question telling us here? Which is the middle digit? Which is the middle digit in the largest number formed by all the digits in the number 14,615? See, here there is number 14,000, or we can say original number 14,651. Now using this, in this number there are digits 1, 4, 6, 5 and 1. These are the digits in the number. digits in the above number. There is 1, there is 4, 6, 5 and 1. Okay. Now what we have to do? We have to form largest number. We have to form largest number using these digits. And each digit used once only we can use each digit. Understood? So see here. The new number, largest number, largest number formed by using these digits. See, now when digits are given and we have to form largest number in that time, at that time what we have to do, we have to arrange the given digit into descending order, that is biggest to smallest order. Okay. So here the biggest digit in this is 6, right? So 6 will write first, then next bigger is 5, then there is 4, and now remain 1 and 1, right? So we will write that 1 and again 1. So we have got this number 65,411. Now the middle digit of this number, middle digit of this number is, middle means the digit we see this 1 2 3 4 5, there are 5 total digits. So this is starting, this is ending, again this is second from starting and this is second from ending, and this 4 is exactly in the middle. So the middle digit of this number is nothing but 4. Understood? Okay, write this in your notebook, and now we'll move towards the next questions. The next question in the exercise 1, that is question number 18. How many two-digit numbers having no zero or a 2 lie between 1 to 50? So see this question. We have to find such two-digit number between 1 to 50 having no zero or a 2. Means in that two digit number there should not be 0 or 2. Such two digit numbers we have to find which lie between 1 to 50. Okay, so see, we will go step by step. That is, numbers are starting from 1. So we will first 1 to 10 we will take, then 11 to 20, then 21 to 30, then 31 to 40, and 41 to 50. So these stages we have formed here, and we will go stage by stage, we will found the numbers. Now between 1 to 10, see, we want two digit number, right? So between 1 to 10 there is only one two-digit number, that is 10 itself. Rest all are single one-digit number. So those numbers will not be included. And 10, if we talk about 10, 10 is having 0. 10 is having 0. So this 10 also will not be included. So here there is no any number, 0. Between 11 to 20, there are total 10 numbers. Out of that, which number has 0 in that? This is 20. 20 has 0, right? And 2 also. So that 20 will not be included, so it will be excluded. And see 12. 12 has 2, right? 12 has 2 in that. So that will be excluded. 12 and 20, between 11 and 20, 12 and 20, these two numbers will be excluded, or will not be counted. So remain 8 numbers, right? So here 11 to 20 we are getting 8 numbers which are 2 digit and there is no 0 or 2 in them. Between 21 to 30, see, between in this stage, third stage, between 21 to 30, see, we don't want 2 in them. Okay, so 21 to 30, from 21 to 29, all numbers have zero, have two in them. Between 21 to 29, all numbers have two. So all those numbers will not be counted or not be included. And 30 remain only 30, but 30 is also having zero. So in 21 to 30, this stage, we are not getting any number which doesn't have 0 or 2. So here also, no numbers. Okay. Then 31 to 40. Again, we are getting here 31 to 40. See, in this 32, there are 10 numbers. Among these 10, 40 is the number with 0. 40 is the number having 0. So that will be excluded, means will not be counted. And again 32 is there having 2. Okay, so these two numbers, 32 and 40, will be excluded and remain 8 numbers. So that 8 will be taken as a for counting. And same with 41 to 50. How many numbers will get in this group of 10 numbers? 41 to 50, again, if you go with this pattern, you will get 8 numbers again. Understood. So total, we are getting how many numbers? So there are 24 numbers. Between 1 to 50 having no 0 or 2. Understood this? Okay. Now we'll move towards the next question. 19. Question number 19. Which of the following is true representation of the number 5317? So see here, expanded form of 5317. Here for that, four options are given, out of which one is correct. So we have to find out that one correct option, which is the true representation or true expanded form of 5317. Okay. So see first one, we'll go by option. See first option number A, 5000 plus 200 plus 21 tens plus 7 units. Units means ones, okay, 7 ones. So here there is 7 ones, here also there is 7 ones. So till this it is correct. See here, how many tens are there? 21 tens. So in this, at this tens place, there is a double digit number, 21. So whenever we do addition, you know, or multiplication, we know if you are getting two digit number, then what we do? We take carry, right? Similarly, here there is 21, no? So what we'll do, this backside number 1 will be here only and 2 will be taken carried in the 100 place. So here, this 2 and this 2 will be added and it will become 400s. Okay. So see, there is 7 units, 1 tens. Is there 1 ten? This is 1s, tens, 100 and 1000. Okay. So we have got 7 unit correct. 1 ten, it is, there is also 1 ten. And see, hundreds. After taking carry these two, here we have got 400. But there is 300s. So this option is cancelled. Okay. Let's check the option B. Again here, starting with the units, there is 7 units, okay, there is 7 units, yes. See tens, there is 21 tens, yes, 21 tens are there. So in the 21 tens, we will do same, here 1 will remain here and 2 will be taken carry at the 100th place. See here, but 100th place is absent. So this 2 will be taken carry at 100th place, so there will be 200 only. As there is 0-100 now, there will be 200. But if you see in this number, there is 300. Okay, so this two, here we are getting 200. So automatically this option also cancelled. We want the 300, but here we are, after taking carry this at 100 place, we are getting 200. Also there is, okay, so to this 200, due to this 200, as there is 300, this option is getting cancelled automatically. Let's go towards the next option, option number C. 4000 plus 1300 plus 7 units. Now in this there is 7 unit. Okay, there is 7 unit. This is okay, true. But there is 110, but here there is no tens, or there is no any number in the ones to take carry in the tens. So this option is getting cancelled. So let's move towards the next option, option D. 4000 plus 1200 plus 11 tens plus 7 units. Now see here, there is 7 unit. Are there 7 unit or 7 ones? Yes. Okay, 11 tens. Now from this 11 tens, there is 2 digit number, right? So this 1, we will take carry here in the 100. So here remain 110. Okay, there are 1200 and this 1 will be added, so they will become 1300. How many hundred? 1300s. Due to this 1, as we have taken this 1 carry here in the 1200, it has become 1300. Now, from this 1300, as this is also 2 digit number, this 1, we will take carry in the 1000. That is 4 plus 1, we are getting 5000. Understood? So see, 5000, this remain here 300, this 1 and 7. 5317. Are we getting? So which option is true representation of the number 5317? Option D. Okay, so answer is option D. This is the correct representation. Understood? Write this in your notebook, and now we'll move towards the next questions of the exercise 1. Let's move towards the next question, that is question number 20. A zero is placed between the digit 4 and 6 of the number 14,651. By how much will the number be increased or decreased? So, you understood the question? See, this is the number they have given, or we can say it is original number. Okay, so what is the original number? 14,651. Now what we have to do here, a zero is placed between the digit 4 and 6. So in this number, this is 4 and 6. So we have to put 0 between 4 and 6 and we have to form new number. So the new number or resulting number we will get C. 1, 4, and here there is 6, so between 4 and 6 we have to put 0. Understood? Then write 6, 5 and 1. So this is the new number we have got. 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 and lakh. The original number is 14,651, correct? And the new number, resulting number we have got here after placing 0 between 4 and 6, that is 1,40,651. So the number is increased or decreased. Increase means the number is the new number is more than the original number or less than original number. Yes, as it is one place is increased, so it is. See, in this number there are 6 digits, in this number there are 5 digits. So obviously the number with more digit is the greater number. So here this number, resulting number or new number, is greater than original number. Okay, so we have to find by how much will the number increase. So it is confirmed that the new number is increased. Now we have to find by how much it is increased. Okay, so to find that by how much it is increased, that means we have to find difference between these two. We have to do the subtraction. So we'll do here 1,40,651 minus 14,651. Okay, now when we subtract the original number from resulting number, the answer which we will get, by that number the new number is increased. So 1 minus 1, 0. 5 minus 5, 0. 6 minus 6, 0. 0 minus 4, yes, not possible. From this 4, we will take 1 borrow here and the 0 will write up. This 4 will remain 3. Now 10 minus 4, 6. 3 minus 1, 2. And this 1. So, the new number is increased by 126,000. So, the new number is increased by 126,000. Okay, that means this new number is more by 126,000 than the original number. Understood? Let's move towards the next question. Question number 21. Write down the following numbers in numerals. Here some number names are given. Initially, previously also we have seen some number names and we have written numeral for them. But this question, though the instruction is same, the examples are different. Okay, see, 12, the first example is 12 and a quarter hundred. See, you write down this, pause the video and write down this in your notebook because I'm going to rub that. See here, the first example is 12 and a quarter hundred. What is meaning of this 12 and a quarter hundred? The meaning of this is 1200 and a quarter hundred. Okay, so 1200, how to write 1200? See, how to write 1200? 12 and 00. This is 1200. Okay, now a quarter hundred means what? A quarter hundred. Quarter means what? In fraction, we have seen. Suppose this is one whole. Suppose this is one whole. Okay, quarter means what? When this will be divided into four equal part. When this will be divided into four equal part, each part is called quarter, one fourth. Quarter means nothing but one fourth. So a quarter hundred, 12 and a quarter hundred means what? 1200 that we have written here. Now we have to find a quarter hundred means what? As I told you, a quarter means one fourth of the hundred. So suppose this is 100. So this 100 we have to divide into four equal parts. 1, 2, 3 and 4. If we want to divide this 100 into four equal parts, in each part, what number we will get? Have you thought? See, 100 means what? If you divide 100 into two equal parts, we will get 50 and 50. Because 50 plus 50, 100, right? Now, if we divide 50 into again two parts, what we will get? 25 and 25. 25 plus 25, 50. And this 25 plus 25, 50. That means 25 plus 25, 50. 25 plus 25, 50. And 50 plus 50, 100. That means if you want to divide 100 into four equal parts, in each part we will get 25, 25, 25 and 25. So these are the four quarters of 100. Remember, quarter means one fourth. Quarter means one fourth of the 100. Okay. So in one quarter there is 25. Another quarter there is 25. Third quarter there is 25. Fourth quarter there is 25. And here we want a quarter 100. A quarter 100 means only one quarter. That is 25. Okay. So there is 1200 and a quarter 100. So total 0 plus 5, 5, 2, 1 and 2, 2 and 1, that is 1225. So 12 and a quarter 100 means 1225, that is 1225. Understood how we obtain this number? 12 and a quarter 100 means 1200 and a quarter 100. So 1200, you know, whenever we see 500, that means after 5 we write 20. Similarly, 1200 means write 12 and write 20 after it. Understood? And a quarter 100 means we have obtained here 25. That 25 will be added in that. Fine. So this way we have obtained 1225. Next, Seven and a half thousand. Seven and a half thousand means 7,000. Now how to write 7,000? This way. 7,000. And a half thousand. Now this here there is fraction half. You know half means, suppose this is whole. This is whole, and when it is divided into two equal parts, each part is called half, correct? Similarly, here half thousand means thousand. We have to divide into two parts. Then in each part, what number we will get? When we will divide thousand into exactly two equal parts, in each part we will get 500 and 500. Understood? That is, this is half thousand and this is half thousand. So here we want a half thousand. So a half thousand is nothing but 500. So that 500 we will add here, because there is 7 and a half thousand. So 7,000 and half thousand. So total 7,500. So 7 and a half thousand means 7,500. Understood? Next. One and three quarter lakh. That means 1 lakh. One complete lakh. How to write 1 lakh? 1 and 5 zeros. Okay, so this is 1 lakh and 3/4 lakh. Again, same pattern. 3/4. 3/4 means, suppose this is one whole, and it, when it is divided into four equal part, each part is called a quarter, right? And we want 3/4. 3/4 means 1, 2, and 3. So here 3/4 lakh. So lakh means this. This is 1 lakh. First we'll divide into 4 quarters. As we divided 100 into 4 quarters, and in each part we got 25. Similarly, when we'll divide 1 lakh into 4 quarters, you know 1 lakh means how many thousands? 1 lakh means 100,000. 1 lakh is made up of 100,000, right? So when we'll divide 1 lakh into 4 parts, each part will have 25,000. 25,000, 25,000, 25,000, and 25,000. As we done for 100, same it is. See here, at that time there were 100, so we got 25, 25, 25, 25. Now here 3 zeros are increased. So here after 25, 3 zeros are increased. That is 25,000. So 25,000 plus 25,000, 50,000. 25,000 plus 25,000, 50,000. And 50 and 50 makes 1 lakh. Understood? So here we want 3/4, right? 1 and 3/4 lakh. So 1 lakh we have written here, and 3/4 lakh. 3 means this is 1/4, this is another quarter, and this is another quarter. Total these 3 quarters we will take. So 25 plus 25 plus 25, we are getting 75,000. Understood? That we'll add here, 75,000. 0, 0, 0, 5, 7 and 1. So we are getting here 1 and 3/4 lakh means 1 lakh and 75,000. Okay, then next, 8 and a quarter crore. Now this is about crore. Pattern is same everywhere. See, in 100 there is 100 ones. Understood? In 1 lakh there is 1,000. So in 1 lakh there is 100,000. In 1 crore there is 100 lakh. Okay. So see here we want crore. 8 and a quarter crore. So first we'll write 8 crore means what? 8 crore. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, and crore. So this is 8 crore. 8 and a quarter crore. So 8 crore and a quarter crore. So 8 crore we have written here. Now here a quarter crore. So this is, here only we'll write ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh. We'll add 2 zeros. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, and crore. This is a crore. This is a crore. When crore is divided into 4 quarters, in each quarter there will be 25 lakh. And we want here a quarter, so we'll take one quarter, that is 25 lakh. Zero, 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 five, two, and 8. That is 8 crore and 25 lakh. Understood, 8 crore and a quarter crore means 25 lakh. Got it? Last one, 29 and 3 quarter 100. Now 29 and 3 quarter 100 means 2900. Now 2900 this way, 2900 and 3 quarter 100. As we have seen previously, when we divided 100 into 4 quarters, we got 25, 25, 25, 25. So 3 quarter means 25, 3 is 75. So 2975. So this way we can solve the exam number names which are given in this form. If you have any doubt regarding this session, you can ask me on WhatsApp group. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.